So far we have discussed about all these structures of IIR filters. Now let us discuss about some problems on IIR filter. This problem covers all the structures of IIR filters. See, realize the following IIR system using direct form 1, direct form 2, cascade structure and parallel structure. Okay, the question will be asked in this form. Y of n is equal to minus 0.1 y of n minus 1 plus 0.2 y of n minus 2 plus 3 x of n plus 3.6 x of n minus 1 plus 0.6 x of n minus 2. Okay, this is the question they have given. See, in your examinations, all the problems will be asked in this model only. Like this only they will ask. So, for that step 1, we will do like this. Y of n is equal to minus 0.1 y of n minus 1. Like this we have to write here and group all y terms on LHS and x terms on RHS. So y of n minus 0.1 will become plus 0.1. Here plus 0.2 into y of n minus 2 will become minus 0.2 here into y of n minus 2 equal to 3 into x of n plus 3.6 x of n minus 1 plus 0.6 x of n minus 2. So you have to group all your y terms into LHS and all your x terms into RHS. Okay, because we have to get our system function h of z. Okay, for that h of z we are doing like this. So apply apply z transform on both sides. Y of n will become y of z plus, see in previous slide, here we are having 0.1 into y of n minus 1. So 0.1 into y of z into z inverse minus 0.2 y of z into z power minus 2 is equal to 3 into x of n there. So z transform of x of n will be x of z plus 3.6 into x of z into z power minus 1. X of n minus 1 is there. So x of z into z inverse. So 0.6 x of z into z power minus 2. So now take out common as y of z in LHS and x of z in RHS. You will get y of z into 1 plus 0.1 into z inverse minus 0.2 into z power minus 2. Okay. So in RHS, x of z into 3 plus 3.6 z power minus 1 plus 0.6 z power minus 2. Okay, this is the z transform. So we have to find out transfer function h of z. We know that h of z is equal to output by input. That is, h of z equal to y of z by x of z. So y of z by x of z is equal to 3 plus, this will become our numerator because this entire term is going here, okay, and this x of z will serves as denominator for y of z. Okay, so y of z by x of z equal to 3 plus 3.6 z inverse plus 0.6 z power minus 2 divided by 1 plus 0.1 z inverse minus 0.2 z power minus 2. Okay, you can realize it in the either same way or else you can take out 3 as common. That is our choice. We know that y of z by x of z output by input gives our h of z. So h of z is equal to like this. Okay, you have to represent like this. Again, I am telling you here, this is 3, you can write as a common factor over here. Okay, in this 3 3.6, 0.6 are all multiples of 3, so you can take out the 3 as common here. So 3 into 1 plus 1.2 z inverse plus 0.2 z power minus 2. So now this is the form that we are going to realize for our direct form 1 and direct form 2 types. For cascade and parallel, there is another method that we will see. First, direct form 1. So for direct form 1, you have to have this one in your mind. Okay. First, we have to realize our x of n. X of n directly goes, and for you have to draw two blocks of z trans z inverse, because the highest power of z is minus 2. So we have to take two blocks. How much is the power of z? That many number of blocks we have to take. If suppose z, if there is an equation which is having z power minus 4 term, means we have to represent z inverse blocks 4 in number. Okay, 4 z inverse blocks are required. And do remember, if any coefficient method, suppose if there is an equation having z power minus 4 as its highest power and the coefficient of z power minus 2 is 0, then you have to represent 0 in that block diagram for z power minus 2. Okay, like that. So for direct form 1, we know that we require individual multipliers for x of z and y of z. So this is z inverse. For z inverse, the coefficient is 1.2. For z power minus 2, the coefficient is 0.2. See, don't write z inverse, z power minus 2, z power minus 3, z power minus 4 like that. Okay, you have to represent only z inverse blocks, because the delay elements or memory elements in our z transforms are z power minus 1. How many number of z power minus 1s are present represents the power of the z that one. Okay. If there are two blocks here, means z power minus 1, z power minus 1. So here, after this z power minus 1, we can treat this as z power minus 2, like that. Okay. So here also, for y of n, here this is 3. We took out it as common, that's why it is 3. And here it is 1. Okay. The denominator always we represent in feedback path. So for feedback path, the coefficient sign will get reversed. So z inverse, here it is minus 0.1, here it is 0.2. All will get added here, and finally this is our y of n. Okay, this is the direct form 1 representation of your IIR filter. So now let us see the direct form 2 representation. We know direct form 2 means it will be with minimum number of multipliers, that is z power minus 1. Here also z power minus 1. Okay. So after this one, this is x of n. So for x of n, it is in feedback path. So 0.1, 0.2 like that. And for y of n, 3, 1.2, 0.2. Okay. So for feedback paths, you have to represent negative sign for the coefficient, and for forward paths there is no sign change in the coefficient. This is the direct form 2 realization. Okay, if you observe the differences between direct form 1 and direct form 2, in this direct form 1 you are having individual delay elements for x of n and y of n. Here there are 2 z inverses, here there are 2 z inverses. Okay. So, but in direct form 2, there are 2 delay elements, z inverse, and here also z inverse. There are 2 blocks, okay, x of n and y of n. Cascade form. Now, the third form is cascade form. So, we know that for cascade form, it has to be in the factors format. That means h of z is equal to hn of z into h2 of z into h3 of z, like that. We will resolve the transfer function into factors. So see here, h of z is equal to, this is the function we are having. So we can take out this one, okay, the numerator 1 plus 1.2 z inverse plus 0.2 z power minus 2. The numerator alone we can take here is equal to, we can write it as 1 plus z inverse plus 0.2 z inverse plus 0.2 z inverse. Now you are having an idea that why we took this 3 outside at initial stage. Okay, the calculation will be very easy. That's why we took 3 as outside. Okay, so 1 plus z inverse plus 0.2 z inverse plus 0.2 z power minus 2. So 1 plus z inverse plus 0.2 z inverse into 1 plus 0.2 z inverse. If you take out common as 0.2 z inverse here, so it can be resolved into factors as like this: 1 plus z inverse into 1 plus 0.2 z inverse. Okay, so now take out the denominator portion. 1 plus 0.2 sorry 1 plus 0.1 z in this denominator portion minus 0.2 z power minus 2. Here this 0.1 can be written as plus 0.5 minus 0.4. So we know that this rule, if you do it to get multiplied like this, the result has to come as 0.2 for square coefficient, square term coefficient. And when by resolving the middle two terms of minus 1 or single power one power coefficient, the result has to come as 0.1. Because of that basic rule, we are resolving into factors like this. This is not only the way to resolve into factors, you can also implement your own methods to resolve the equations into factors. Okay, so this is 0.5 minus 0.4. So 1 plus 0.5 z inverse minus, you can take out the 0.4 z inverse as common into 1 plus 0.5 z inverse. If you take 1 plus 0.5 z inverse as common in both, it will come as 1 minus 0.4 z power minus 1. So the factors for denominator is 1 plus 0.5 z inverse into 1 minus 0.4 z inverse. So now h of z can be written as 3 into 1 plus 0.2 z inverse into 1 plus z inverse divided by 1 plus 0.5 z inverse into 1 minus 0.4 z inverse. So finally you can take it as h1 of z is equal to anything you can take. You can randomly select this term by this term, or this term by this term, or you can pair up these two, or else you can pair up these two. That depends on our own interest. Okay, or else you can just simply multiply 3 with everything, and also you can do the same. So here h1 of z is equal to 1 plus 0.2 z inverse by 1 plus 0.5 z inverse. H2 of z equal to 1 plus z power minus 1 by 1 minus 0.5 z inverse. So this is h1 of z and this is h2 of z. You can represent now h of z is equal to h1 of z into h2 of z into 3. Okay, we are not supposed to forget about this 3. If you forget about 3, then all our calculations will go wrong in further steps. So the 3 is still there. Finally, we will multiply the whole term with 3. So this is the cascade representation. So first we will realize the h1 of z, and next we will realize the h2 of z. The output of h1 of z will be connected to input of h2 of z, and final output will be multiplied by the 3. Okay. So this is the representation that we are using. Here is direct form 2 representation. In cascade, we need 2 or more stages. Each individual stage is represented by direct form 1 or else direct form 2 stages. Okay, this is h1 of z. You can write as 1 plus 0.2 z inverse by 1 plus 0.5 z inverse. Okay, the output of the stage is here. This is connected as input to next stage. So next stage will be 1 plus z inverse divided by 1 minus 0.4 z power minus 1. And finally the output will get multiplied by 3. This is the cascade form. If they did not mention anything in the question, it means we have to take defaultly in cascade form, we have to use direct form 2 method. Okay. Or else if they mention in bracket cascade form using direct form 1 or cascade form using direct form 2, then you have to use that direct form 1 itself. If they don't ask anything means, if they don't specify anything means, always go for minimum number of delay elements that is present in our direct form 2 method. Okay. So next, parallel form. For parallel form, we'll take the help of partial fractions. So we are taking this one, 0.6 z power minus 2 plus 3.6 z power minus 1 plus 3. For this one, we are for the numerator, we are factorizing it with the help of minus 3. So if you multiply with minus 3, you can get minus 0.2 z inverse plus 0.1 z power minus 1 plus 1. This method we also know that. So by cancelling this term, okay, by simply changing signs over here, this, it has plus, it will become minus, it has minus, it will become plus, it has minus, it will become plus. So 0.6 z power minus 2, 0.6 z power minus 2 will get cancelled, and 3.6 plus 3, 0.3, 3.9, and 3 plus 3, it will be 6. So you can represent as h of z is equal to minus 3 plus 3.9 z inverse plus 6 divided by 1 plus 0.1 z power minus 1 minus 0.2 z power minus 2. Okay, the numerator has been resolved like this. Okay, so simply take out the LCM and you can represent this term. You can take out this term, 3.9 z inverse plus 6 divided by this whole term is equal to, see here we are factorizing the denominator. These factors that we have already achieved while doing cascade form, we can use those factors in parallel form also. Okay, because the entire steps we have done factorizing or else in cascade form, give an equation to that and utilize that equation here. Okay, so now I am substituting them directly. You can write as a by 1 minus 0.4 z inverse plus b by 1 plus 0.5 z inverse. So h of z will become minus 3 plus 3.9 z inverse plus 6 divided by 1 plus 0.1 z power minus 1 minus 0.2 z power minus 2, that equal to minus 3 plus a by 1 minus 0.4 z inverse plus b by 1 plus 0.5 z inverse. Okay, now if you do partial fractions like that, comparing cross multiple, taking LCM and then comparing on both sides. Okay, so compare coefficients of z inverse, you will get a and b values. Okay, so put z inverse is equal to minus 0.1 by 0.5. So by substituting that one over here, we can get b value as 1 by simplification. See, 1 plus 0.5 z inverse is equal to 0. That is the term by that we have got by comparing both sides. So z inverse is equal to minus 1 by 0.5. If you substitute z inverse is equal to minus 1 by 0.5 in the above equation, this equation, you will get, here 0.5, 0.5 will get cancelled. So this is 1 minus 1. So entire a term will becomes 0. And here b term is there. Okay. So by evaluating this b term on both sides, we got b is equal to 1. Okay, so next, so after by substituting z z inverse is equal to 1 by 0.4. You can get, that means to make this b as 0, okay, we can get a value. So a into 1 plus 0.5 0.4 plus b into 1 minus 0.4 into 1 by 0.4, that means this 0.4, this 0.4 will get cancelled and 1 minus 1 will become, and this entire b term will tends to 0. Or else you can simply substitute, okay, b value also here. So by substituting here, 3.9 into 1 by 0.4 plus 0.6 divided by 1 plus 0.5 divided by 1.4 equal to this one. Finally, we'll get a equal to 7 and b is equal to 1. So by substituting those values here, okay, 3.9 into z inverse plus 6 divided by 1 plus 0.1 z inverse minus 1 0.2 z power minus 2 is equal to 7 by 1 minus 0.4 z inverse plus 1 by 1 plus 0.5 z power minus 1. So finally h of z is equal to minus 3 plus this whole term. So minus 3 plus 7 by 1 minus 0.4 z inverse plus 1 by 1 plus 0.5 z inverse is there. So substitute and represent it out parallelly. See, minus 3 term is there. So minus 3 can be represented like this, and we have to keep an arrow mark here. And h1 of z is nothing but 7 divided by 1 minus 0.4 z inverse. So only feedback term and one delay element is there. So you can just represent z inverse, and this is 0.4 here, okay, it is going here, and then this is 7, okay. Here we can represent our 7, or else you can represent 7 here also. So here next, minus 1 by 1 plus 0.5 z inverse. We have to write plus here, and you have to represent, treat it as minus 1 here. Either you can represent in the previous way, you have to treat it like this. That means it will be easy for us, because just we are adding only add, because we are using only adders here, okay. So here minus 1 is the coefficient after multiplication. So 1 by z inverse into 0 minus 0.5. If you observe, these are in feedback path. So the feedback path coefficient signs has to get reversed, because here 1 minus 0.4 z inverse is there. You have to represent 1 plus 0.4 z inverse. Here 1 plus 0.5 z inverse is there. You have to represent 1 minus, here minus 0.5 like that. So after getting this one, the inputs, all input has joined to x of n, and all outputs has to get added. Here there are 3 terms, okay, that's why the minimum multiply adders we require is 2 adders. If we have two terms alone, then we can add, we can use only one adder here. By adding all those two, finally the y of n will be out, okay. These are the 4 representations of your IIR filter: direct form 1, direct form 2, cascade, and then parallel. So I hope you understand this one. We have to do more workouts on this method of problems in third unit, because these are very, very important for your examinations, and also not only for examinations, if you do more number of problems, you'll be having a very good analytical skills developed in you, okay.